stocks markets in Asia opening mixed after a tech-driven rally on Wall Street. Let's take a look at the board. Shares in Australia, even futures for Hong Kong pointing lower. While Japan is seeing some modest gains, the Nikkei 225 up by about 0.5%. The yen fairly steady after softening yesterday. The currency had earlier slumped to its weakest against the dollar since 1990, prompting many to speculate authorities will start to intervene. Meanwhile, gold climbing to a fresh record after the latest U.S. inflation print, that is the producer price index, offered some calm to the markets. Up ahead, we are waiting to get China's trade numbers. Now, stateside, U.S. futures looking pretty good, with the Dow leading gains up by 0.1% for futures, and the S&P and the Nasdaq also marginally higher when trading resumes tonight, Manila time. Now, in commodities again, oil resuming gains ahead of a report from the International Energy Agency on the outlook as traders brace for a potential strike on Israel by Iran or its proxies. The West Texas Intermediate climbing towards $86 a barrel after closing 1.4% lower the previous session, while Brent settled near $90. Oil now on track for a weekly loss, but prices are still around 19% higher this year, in part due to OPEC Plus supply cuts. The world's largest tech companies drove a rebound on Wall Street Thursday, with traders now bracing for a deluge of results from corporate America that could test or support this year's $4 trillion rally. Earnings season kicks into full swing today with JP Morgan Chase, Wells Fargo, and Citigroup Inc. reporting their numbers. According to a Bloomberg data, a 3.8% projected annual earnings growth per share for Q1 for S&P 500 members is being priced in. Also helping lift sentiment was an inflation report focused on producer prices, showing a rise, but one that trailed estimates and already showing some relief in key categories, rekindling hopes that inflation, while ticking higher, remains in a cooling trend. Let's take a look at the board. The S&P hovering near 5,200, while the Nasdaq is up by 1.7%. That says Alphabet got closer to the $2 trillion mark. Amazon also hitting a record high, while Apple jumped on news that it plans to overhaul its Mac line.
Economically, we've had a really good quarter. Until just the last few days, even, we've seen rates move down all quarter, and we had a strong stock market. So I expect these bank earnings to be really strong. We're going to be looking at JP Morgan first thing in the morning. We're looking at BlackRock. That's going to really reflect some of those trends in the market. What I care most about is what they see going forward. I think we're going to have strong earnings from the quarter, maybe even upside surprises. But given the stickiness of inflation that we're seeing, we're really going to want to hear what these banks see in their business trends for the next quarter and the rest of the year.
The euro dropped after the European Central Bank signaled cooling inflation will soon allow it to cut rates. Now, here is a look at the local corporate headlines we're watching this morning. State Pension Fund Social Security System has chosen Metrobank to manage a 1.5 billion peso balanced fund by investing in various equities and fixed income assets. Metrobank Trust's mandate actually started back in February and is slated to run for the next 3 years. And Medalco Energy, or MServe, has been tapped by Allied Care Experts, or ACE Group of Hospitals, for the installation of electrical facilities that are crucial to the day-to-day operations of two medical centers in the country. MServe turned over the load-side facilities that include two first private poles and six 250 kVA transformers for San Jose del Monte Muzon Medical Center in Bulacan and ACE Medical Center Sari Aya in Quezon. ACE Group of Hospitals is a nationwide network of hospitals which currently has around 30 medical centers nationwide. And we have this Justin Jerry, or Global Estate Resorts Inc., a premier developer of integrated tourism and leisure townships owned by the Andrutan Group, as actually reporting net income to parent company shareholders grew 3% to 1.8 billion pesos for 2023, as consolidated revenues grew by 14% to 8.3 billion pesos. They're saying the exceptional growth was propelled by strong performance across its business segments, including real estate, estate, rental, and hotel operations. Just a bit of a background and a breakdown. Real estate sales actually grew 10%, hitting 6.5 billion pesos, driven by improvements of real estate bookings from the company's projects in Boracay New Coast, Southwood City, and Twin Lakes. Reservation sales, meantime, hitting 19.2 billion pesos, marking its full recovery from 2019 and highlighting the sustained demand for its innovative property offerings. Hotel segment benefiting from a resurgence in travel back online tourism, recording a 35% surge in revenues to 567 million pesos. We do know that Cherry has 9 tourism estates and integrated lifestyle communities across the country, covering more than 3,300 hectares of land. Time now to zip through the top headlines from major business papers from Business World. Philippine rice imports totaled 1.15 million metric tons in the first quarter. That's up 44% year on year, the country's Plant Industry Bureau says. Vietnam remains the country's top supplier of rice, accounting for 62% of all imports. From Business Mirror, Manila ranks 121st out of 142 cities worldwide in an index that measures cities' readiness and utilization of advanced technologies to foster sustainable communities. The Philippine capital's ranking in this year's Smart City Index was 6 notches lower than its 115th finish last year. And from the Philippine Star, the Philippine Education Department reports so far some 5,800 of the 48,000 public schools nationwide, that's about 10%, a little more than 10%, have suspended in-person classes due to the hot weather worsened by the El Nino phenomenon. Now, here's a quick look at the flash business headlines from overseas. A Vietnam court sentences real estate tycoon Truong Mai Lan to death for her role in a $12 billion fraud case. The chairwoman of Van Tran Phat Group was arrested in 2022 for charges including bribery of government officials and violation of bank lending rules. She was also accused of embezzling funds from Saigon Commercial Bank between 2018 to 2022. Lan's trial put the spotlight on Vietnam's years-long anti-corruption campaign spearheaded by the Communist Party. In other news, shares of Morgan Stanley fell 5.3% to nearly $87 on Thursday, the most in 5 months, after a report that U.S. regulators are scrutinizing the firm's efforts to prevent potential money laundering by wealthy clients. The increase focused on the firm's wealth management arm, generating almost half the company's revenue last year. The U.S. government has been ramping up pressure on the industry to tighten money laundering controls. Moving on, an analyst says UBS might need to retain $10 to $15 billion in excess capital after the Swiss government laid out plans for tougher capital requirements for the enlarged lender. Autonomous research analyst Stefan Stallman says UBS would need 200 to 300 basis points more in Common Equity Tier 1 ratio, which is a measure of a bank's resilience. The government's recommendations is part of New Switzerland's efforts to shield the country from a repeat of the collapse of Credit Suisse. In other news, Ford set to ship 144,000 of its redesigned F-150, its best-selling model and Ranger pickup truck, to North American dealers. Ford stopped the shipment of these vehicles earlier due to quality problems. Its latest move will be critical for Ford to hit its 2024 pre-tax profit target of $10 to $12 billion. Meanwhile, Apple preparing to overhaul its entire Mac line with a new family of in-house processors designed to highlight artificial intelligence. The company, which released its first Macs with M3 chips 5 months ago, is reportedly nearing production of the next generation M4 processor. The new chip will come in at least 3 main varieties, and Apple is looking to update every Mac model with it. The new chips are part of Apple's broader push to weave AI capabilities into all of its products. And finally, Taylor Swift's music now back on TikTok despite an ongoing dispute between her record label and the social video platform. Universal Music Group pulled the songs of its recording artists and songwriters from TikTok in February after failing to come to terms on a new licensing agreement. Universal said TikTok failed to adequately compensate it for the songs, while TikTok accused the record label of putting its own interests above that of the artists. The timing also coincides with the impending release of Swift's newest album, The Tortured Poets Department, on April 19th.